classes in Gainesville. It's really easy, 8 steps. You just put them together and do them real fast and smile the whole time. So anyhow, then we'll morph into something a little bit faster that we put on our new class people after they learn the first one.
Thank you. an Appalachian set, and this is new for us, and I did some research a few years ago because I wanted to know what is authentic Appalachian square dancing. And this is what we came up with. This is after I read a book, talked to Tom Green from Tallahassee. He's the one that got me on the right track and told me which book to read, the research I needed to do, and this is what we came up with, the Appalachian set.
Thank you.
And we are going to start in the 1600s in Ireland. And clogging is what's called a percussive dance, which means that you use your feet as if they were the drums. So Piper is going to illustrate a form of Irish dancing called Shanos. Take it away, Piper. Thank you, Piper. Wasn't that wonderful? Now we are going to cross the little body of water to England. And during the Industrial Revolutions in the 1800s, late 19th century, workers in the mills in England would wear wooden shoes because the floors were so wet to protect their feet. Sort of like here at the Folk Festival this year. Wouldn't you love to have some wooden clogs? So Julie and Alita are going to demonstrate where the word clogging comes from. And this is called English clogging, and they're going to do a lovely waltz for us. Take it away, Julie and Alita. Is going to do a fabulous rendition of Gene Kelly's famous number, Singing in the Rain, also appropriate for this year's Folk Fest. Take away Nolan. Steps from a whole bunch of us cloggers. Potluck.